Hello and welcome to my presentation at DEFCON 29 Recon Village. My name is Ladislav Bacho and I will talk about how vigilant researchers can uncover APT attacks for fun and non-profit. I will be talk about threat intelligence, hunting malware samples and malware analysis. I will present how even individual researchers without funding and without access to premium services can uncover interesting targeted attacks. I start with the introduction of our arsenal, with keeping in mind that it should be available for enthusiasts and it should be budget friendly. Next, I will share a couple of tips how to perform advanced search for interesting malware samples, and following the case study, I will analyze one Cobalt Strike sample targeting government of one small European country. During this investigation, I discovered several command and control servers, which have been reported to the local authorities then. At the end of the day, it turns out that even vigilant individual researcher can help with defending and targeting the targeted cyber attack. So, this is our agenda, and now let me allow to tell a few words about myself. So, who am I? I am Ladislav Bacho. I am a senior security consultant and malware analyst with more than 10 years of experience in cybersecurity, etc. I currently work as a head of research department in Istrosec cybersecurity company, and during my previous engagements I worked for Slovakia government and for the clients located in United States, especially in New York. Now let's start with introducing the budget-friendly toolkit of the individual researcher. Of course, there are plenty of threat intelligence feeds and OSINT resources. However, everything has its cost. While there are many free resources, sometimes they have a questionable quality. And the right context is also very important. But with enough time for testing and evaluating, you can find free feeds with very good coverage of your needs. And what about APT attacks? Oh, there are a lot of malware samples available from older and already analyzed campaigns. However, with precise targeting and advanced search capabilities, even individuals and vigilant researchers can uncover current and ongoing campaigns. A few examples of resources for malware samples. There are online repositories such as Malware Bazaar and especially VX Underground with very interesting collections of samples for educational purposes. And these collections include also samples from APT attacks. On the other hand, when we want to find a gold, we need to analyze mostly current or uncategorized samples. Online services such as Malware Bazaar, Hybrid Analysis, AnyRun and Triage provide public feeds. Probably the most easy option for processing and automation is Hybrid Analysis and Malware Bazaar. Also, there are very useful advanced search capabilities and filters available at AnyRun and Hybrid Analysis. And for linking between artifacts, VirusTotal relations act as a great knowledge base. One part of the researcher toolkits are data and feeds, but we also need tools for their processing. One good example of open source threat intelligence platform is Yeti, which stands for Your Everyday Threat Intelligence. It integrates feeds, analytics, search capabilities, exports, but also can provide investigation tool similar to VirusTotal Graph or Maltego. and it can be completely hosted on your hardware. This is the example of tools similar to VirusTotalGraph. This is example of feed and search in Yeti platform. Another great tool from my experience is Twitter, because a lot of researchers report their news via tweets. So we can use the tweets as a feed and search for IOCs, or indicator of compromise, as we can see the example of tweetioc.com. Also, a very useful tool is called Twint, which we'll cover a little bit later. Okay, so we have resources and tools, and now how to use them for malware hunting. First of all, advanced search and filters are our good friends. For example, on hybrid analysis, we have plenty of available options. Also, please notice that there are more options too at the bottom of the search form. And the hybrid analysis has also capabilities of string search and search by YARA rules, which is also very useful. NRAN offers also a useful filter. I especially like the submission country filters. This is this one. And the context. Because it is a good idea to search for rare samples in these context fields instead of the object fields. And the last tool is Twint, an advanced command line utility, the advanced Twitter scraping and OSINT tool, which doesn't use Twitter API. And therefore, it can bypass the most of Twitter API limitations, and you do not need any Twitter account for use Twint. Together with standard Linux tools such as grep, the Twint tool is very powerful when searching for something very specific. After collecting and analyzing malware samples, we usually get a couple of network IOCs, such as IP addresses and domain names, and we are ready for hunting the another command and control servers, which may be linked to the investigated campaign. For this task, the search engines such as Shodan or Sensis are very handy. Sensis has a great search language and filters, but those filters only work for some network services and protocols supported by Sensis. For general searching, Shodan is also a very good choice. And moreover, they also offer a history of their scans and the results, which is a kind of web archive for internet-connected devices. And also web archive is a very good tool when I want to see something from the history of websites. But in general, I usually use combination of all of these three services for my CNC hunting. As a bonus, there is one professional tip for Shodan. A search by hash. Especially with HTTP favicon hash, it is possible to search for all online instances of the same web application or product. For example, admin interface interface of home routers and firewalls could be found with HTTP favicon hash filter. Here is also example how we can compute more and more hash tree for these hash searches, because this hash is not the standard hash like MD5 or SHA-1 or SHA-256, but it is more and more hash tree instead. So, this is the last slide of the theory. How to hunt for interesting malware samples. When talking about APT style attacks targeting specific industry or government, it is much easier to search among sample submissions from small country instead of big countries, because there are much more common sample submissions from countries with great population than from the small countries. It is more difficult for us to find the gold. As a comparison, when we apply any run country filters, there are big differences in number of results or number of pages with the results, to be precise. We can see that from the small European countries with the population under 20 million, such as Austria, Belgium, Czech Republic, Hungary, also Netherlands and Slovakia, there are significantly less submissions than from the big countries. Especially I would like to point to Slovakia with very small numbers of submissions. Also, there are a couple of exceptions. For example, from Netherlands and Poland, there are more submissions per population than in the other countries, but there can be a reason for that. For example, in Poland, there are a lot of researchers and great community, and in the Netherlands, there are free Proton VPN servers available for anonymization of the researchers from another countries. So this could be a reason why number of submissions from Netherlands are slightly higher as its population suggests. Now we can put our theory in the practice. The following results are from my personal research in March and April 2021. I started on AnyRun with the country filter set to Slovakia only. The reason is was explained a few seconds ago. So, somebody submitted the sample called aktualizaciu.img to the sandbox AnyRun on 23rd March 2021. This sample, this particular one, has been submitted again a couple of days later on 9th April. Probably someone was already or again investigating the attack, or somebody checked if the sample is already detected as malicious after couple of days, because in this run the sample was not detected as a threat. Yes, the sample without any detections are good candidates when we are hunting for rare malware, because they can stay under the radar of antivirus engines and other security systems. Also, this one particular sample attracted my attention with the letters NBU. I will explain it a little bit later. But on this screenshot, you can also see other submissions. This is a phishing which looks like phishing targeting Financial Bureau of Slovak Republic. And this is something like a phishing targeting one bank in Slovak Republic and so on, but as I pointed, the NBU letters attracted my attention especially. So, the volume name of this sample, which is ISO file system, is interesting. It contains NBU letters, and NBU is abbreviation of the National Security Authority or NSA in Slovakia. Also, aktualizácia means update in Slovak language. So file name is looks like it has something with some update. So this sample tries to look like something related to local NSA, which is, by the way, the main authority of cybersecurity in Slovak Republic. The NSA ISO sample contains two files, one LNK file and one DLL file. The LNK file, or link file, or Windows shortcut, actually executes the DLL file from ISO via run DLL32 program. So with this LOLBIN technique, it can stay under the radar. LOLBIN means living of the land binary, and those techniques are often used by the attacker. Referring to the access time of link file, this file has been accessed 30 minutes before the ISO file system has been created. Therefore, there is probably no automation in the packaging process of the malware sample, and the payload for delivery has been created manually by human, as we will discuss later. On the other hand, when the time difference between malware stages is much lesser, it could be a strong assumption of automated build process and a mass targeted malware sample. DLL file is a loader or packer with some anti-analysis protections enabled. In the picture, there is an unpacking routine consisting of decryption loops, followed by the call to virtual protect Windows API, and then the call to unpacked payload itself. This is a very common obfuscation technique used by loaders. The malicious code is unpacked into memory, then protection of the memory region is set to executable, and the original payload is executed as a code instead of data. The unpacked payload is DLL file, but without standard MS-DOS header, like this program cannot be run in DOS mode, etc. This malformed header can be often seen in, for example, in Metasploit Meterpreter payloads, and it is used as a part of shellcode when the loader can jump directly to the first byte of the payload, and this malformed header is then executed, and it redirects the execution flow to the original entry point of the payload. This DLL file from payload is actually a CobaltStrike beacon. CobaltStrike is a commercial pentesting tool similar to the Metasploit. The beacon configuration can be easily extracted using the various tools and scripts which are available from the researchers to the researchers as community tools. Those scripts can be found, for example, on GitHub, by the way. It is often a good idea to check if somebody already solved our problem, and we do not need to reinvent the wheel again, in this case, to manually extract CobaltStrike beacon configuration. On the other hand, it is good to understand the principles and to be able to create tools from your arsenal or to do the things manually if needed. Never mind. Here are the excerpts from the extracted configuration. From this config, we can see that this is HTTP or HTTPS beacon based on jQuery malleable C2 profile. Also, in general, I would like to point to the watermark field in the CobaltStrike configs. The watermark is a value associated with the license file of CobaltStrike, and it should be unique to the customer. For that reason, it can be used to track and linking CobaltStrike samples together, if they are used by the same threat actor. However, in our case, this watermark is not unique, as we can see. In the time of the analysis, it has been used by plenty of CobaltStrike servers because many threat actors used leaked or pirated versions with reused or forged watermarks. During the analysis of Cobalt Strike command and control server, I discovered a couple of interesting things. It is powered by Nginx web server with Let's Encrypt certificate issued 7 days before the Cobalt Strike payload was packed into ISO file. Without any parameters, the HTTP requests are redirected to the spectator.sme.sk, a popular English version of Slovakia online newspaper. Now we can try to find more command and control servers. Usually, the thread actors host their servers in the same network or provider. In our case, the server is hosted at Canadian OVH hosting. We can also use search filters based on CNC configuration. For example, we can search for servers with the same open ports, such as HTTPS, maybe also HTTP, and SSH for remote management. Also, Cobalt Strike Team Server by default listens on port 50,050, but not in this case. My first search resulted in more than 800 of thousands of results, so the better filter is needed, definitely. With adjusted filter to include Nginx web servers, the number of results is reduced, but it is still not enough for my need. So let's think about it. How we can create precise filter from the information we already have? We have a lot of website info, so try to find some unique combination of properties, which are not so strict individually, but together they will act as a good fingerprinting of the CNC servers belonging to this campaign. Especially, we know that there is Nginx web server with a redirection and a no referrer policies. Also, content length sounds kind of unique. So after a couple of tries, the winner is this query, which reduced to only 6 potential CNC web servers. Now it is feasible to check them manually, and we can find if there are also Cobalt Strike servers and examine their configuration. This is one example, and again, there is a redirection to the news portal, and there are other similar properties, such as content length, Nginx web server, a no referrer policy, etc. But this time, this is SecTiGo SSL certificate instead of Let's Encrypt one. Based on those observations, it is possible to discover more CNC servers. Some of them are hosted in OVH, and many of them have SSL and TLS certificates issued by SecTiGo instead of Let's Encrypt. They have been active since February 2021, but probably some of them was also used back in 2020. These CNC servers also incorporated the redirection to innocent websites, and they use similar domains by themselves. The discovered CNC servers are located around the globe, for example, in Canada, France, and Australia. Now it is possible to extract Cobalt Strike configurations from those CNC servers. Again, there are tools available, including the nmap script for this. With information about CNC infrastructure, I have found another malware samples linked to the same thread actor. We can use IP addresses and domains and file type filters for our searching. For example, another ISO file submitted with the name evil.iso, however, its original name was invitation.iso. This file is very similar to the analyzed NSA ISO. It contains a link and a DLL file with Cobalt Strike beacon payload. It was submitted to NIRAN in February 2021 from Netherlands. My hypothesis is that some analysts use the ProtonVPN, which is often used by researchers for protecting their privacy, as we mentioned earlier. Please also notice the same software has been used for building of these samples, and another common properties such as volume block count, volume set name, etc. Based on similarities of analyzed ISO files, I was able to find another similar files. This time, string search in hybrid analysis and daytime filter was successful. It means that at least some of the malware samples have been delivered via phishing emails with Word documents as an attachment. Moreover, it seems that the same threat actor delivers at least one phishing email to the targets in private companies such as Foxconn in March 2021 too. But when the examining of sender IP address from the email headers, it turns out that this email came from the Netwire botnet, which is not very unusual. Many attackers started with the massive phishing campaigns, and later, when they found that they successfully compromised valuable victims, they will continue with something more advanced, such as another malware, including Cobalt Strike. Or they can rent services from another threat actor group for their own malicious purposes. Nevertheless, when we look on the sender IP address and we use a Shodan history, we can see that in the March 2021, there were a Windows server publicly accessible with open remote desktop protocol. So this is interesting fact. So findings and summary. We were able to discover and track the campaign targeting Slovakia government and Cobalt Strike infrastructure used by the threat actor. This analysis is based solely on publicly available information, community threat intelligence sources, and my own malware research. The incident and the results have been reported to the local authorities, such as Computer Security Incident Response Team. The report included the collected indicators of compromise, such as hashes and IP addresses. These IOCs have been used during the investigation. Imagine it is like the Oraculum. You can predict which IP addresses will the attacker use in the next steps, or you can use the reported IOCs as a pivot during the forensic analysis. All the results are only from the hunting in public sources. Takeaways from this talk. First of all, I presented a couple of tips and tricks for malware hunting and advanced search. Second, we can see that even independent researcher without funding can be hunter and can help. This is how profit, fun and non-profit hobby of researchers can turn into profit for the society. And finally, here are example indicator of compromise from the samples mentioned during this talk. If anyone would like to try his own analysis, malware samples are available for download from NIRAN after the free registration. So that's all from me, and if you are interested, you can read something about my work and research on my personal blog or on our company website, and you can find me also on Twitter. So thank you very much for attending this talk, and if you have any questions, please feel free to ask me.